What does it mean, shift left, when we are talking about container security? In this episode, we're going to learn more about Azure Defender for Azure Container Registries and how we are building a solution that will allow you to shift left, work closer to your developer to ensure that the images that you upload are more secure. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. Welcome everyone to Azure Security Center in the Field, episode 22. Today we are going to talk about containers. And before I dive into our topic and present our guest, I just want to make sure that you subscribe to our Microsoft Secure channel. We are posting these shows every other week, but on top of that, we have a lot of content that we are releasing every week on the Microsoft Security channel. So make sure to click on the bell to receive notifications when new videos are uploaded. With that, I want to introduce you to our guest, Denis Mizetski. Denis, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Yuri. Thank you for inviting me to the great series. I'm really excited to be part of it.
Absolutely, it's great to have you here. Denis, can you please tell us more about your work at Microsoft, what you do, what are some of the things that you are currently working on?
Sure, then I've recently joined Azure Security Center team 3 or 4 months ago, and covering several areas, some of them in container security area, and mainly in Azure Defender for Container Registries, and I think that this is what we're going to deep dive in this session.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's exactly the goal. So this episode is fully dedicated to Azure Defender for Container Registries. We had one with Maya that we gave an overview about Container Registries and also Kubernetes, but this one is fully focused on ACR. Azure Defender for ACR. So I would like to start asking you, what is the current challenge for container security from your perspective?
And thanks for asking. Actually, you know, we had a great mileage since GA last year. We see, you know, exponential growth and adoption of the feature. And when we're talking about container security overall, then maybe I would like to share a few slides.
Absolutely,
with you.
Yeah. Let's do it. Go ahead.
Yeah. Then you know, while we can look on the on the registry and or images that are stored in, you know, in the registries as an object that we would like to secure, it will be much more important to zoom out maybe for a moment and try to look into, you know, whole container security picture. We can identify zero vulnerabilities in runtime as a North Star for overall container security, but there are quite a few steps, you know, until we get into the runtime. So we should take care of all these steps and see how we can secure the image before. Then it starts with build, and then we proceed to ship, deploy, and then actually we are getting into runtime, right? Then the nature of containers that provides kind of better security for default due to, you know, immutability of image creates new challenges. That in order to fix some vulnerabilities, and like with VMs, you actually need to go back to the build step. And this is called, you know, this concept is called security shift left. So is you know, as early as possible. As you detect a vulnerability, it enables us to fix it much faster, and we should do it as close as possible to, you know, to developers that that build new image. So when we talk about container registry security, we concentrate on the build and on the ship areas right now, and we're looking into our roadmap to complete these new features that are coming soon. You know, also in deployment and runtime area.
Great, great, great explanation, great overview. So now let's go to our solution, Azure Defender for Container Registries. Can you give us a little overview about what are the current capabilities that we have?
Yeah. Great question. So when we concentrate on Azure Defender for Container Registries, we talk about few components, and you know the main one there is the scan engine, which is based on industry-leading provider Qualys. The Qualys scanner runs inside Azure, so no image leaves your Azure region. We're bringing signatures and updates from Qualys into Azure, and then we're scanning your images in the same region where your Azure Container Registry resides. The findings about scanned images are pushed into Azure Security Center and surfaced there as recommendations, or you can review your results also under the inventory blade. And it's very important to understand that Qualys scanner is not a regular, open source static scanner. It's actually a dynamic scanning engine, and it surfaces both standard CVEs that can be detected by, inspecting of image layers, but it also have a more sophisticated algorithm to detect active vulnerabilities in image as a whole.
All right. So this architecture diagram is basically how things work behind the scenes when we push a container registry and go through the scan, and then provides all the actionable recommendations and vulnerabilities classification.
Exactly.
Excellent. Well, with that, I'd like to dive a little bit in more detail about the vulnerability scan itself. Is it possible to perform vulnerability scanning in the CI/CD pipeline, or only after runtime?
Okay, it's a good question. When we just GA the Azure Defender for Container Registries, we initially supported only scans on ship phase, which was triggered when you pushed the image or imported image from another registry. Later in September, we added the capability to continuously scan or rescan your active images that were pulled in the last 30 days. And this is particularly important feature because lots of vulnerabilities are detected after the image was built, or even after it was deployed. And these continuous rescan capabilities were just GA'd earlier this month. But to complete the whole story, and bring real security shift left, we are working on image scan, bringing image scan into CI/CD pipelines. We're currently in private preview for this feature, and based on the customer feedback, we're planning to proceed to public preview later in this quarter.
That's great news. That's great news for sure. Mm-hmm. And with that, one common question that we always receive is if it is possible to force a manual scan in runtime.
Then currently we actively rescan any image that was pulled in last 30 days on weekly basis. Then you don't really need to force anything. As long as image is active, we will scan it, and active it means if it was pushed, pulled, or imported. There is no way to trigger or to force rescan right now. It's something on our backlog, and we're looking into bringing this in next half of this year.
Okay, so this is also good news, and you heard here first. It's something that we are evaluating, and potentially will come to reality. Well, yeah. It's all really good news. It's all really interesting. But our audience really appreciates some demo. So I know that you brought some demo for us today. So let's prepare here the environment, open Azure Security Center, and let's get started here.
Great. Then let's first look into how you enable this stuff, right? In order to enable Container Registry Scan, you need to go to Pricing and Settings and enable the bundle for Container Registries, this one. It's important to understand that the charge is done per image. You pay only one time for every image. And it doesn't matter how many times we're going to rescan. Once you pushed it, imported, we will continuously rescan this image until it's active and used. Then what happens after you enable this bundle? You will start getting the recommendations for images found in Container Registries. For example, let me take this one. And what we can see here is that I have two unhealthy registries. It means that there are some images, for example, there are 12 images out of 13 images that were found with vulnerabilities in these registries. You have some kind of summary of how many vulnerabilities you get here, and you also have a details of what kind of vulnerabilities you got. In addition to this, you can also see what are the remediation steps, and it can be a bit painful for images actually, because the only way to fix image is to go and build a new one with a new package. And you can see the affected resources. But when I'm going back to the vulnerability itself, you can also go and click on the vulnerability and see a bit more details on this, why we find, why we recommend to do something with this, links to the CVEs. If there is a patch or fix, then we will also tell you what you should do or what you should install. For example, in this case, you will need to install these fixes. And you also see the list of images that are affected by this vulnerability. Then this is particularly important for the security team or for SecOps or for CISO to view this screen. But there is another angle that we can leverage, and this is actually more for workload owners or for registry owners. We can go to inventory. In Inventory Blade, you will see all the Azure resources to make your life a bit easier. And if you want to get just the container registers here, let's filter out everything else and just get the container registries. For example, here I have two container registers that are monitored by Azure Defender for ACR. And when I deep dive into the registry itself, I will get the list of all recommendations related to this specific registry and what I'm recommended to do. Then this view is particularly important for registry owners.
That looks great. That looks great. That's a really good approach to go through the inventory to get that. Great stuff. Now, one question that is very common is from the initial recommendations that you were showing. So if you go back to that initial recommendation, how can I export that list of recommendations?
And actually, like any other recommendation, you can have, you can download the CSV report here, but if I am going to the recommendation itself, I go to this one. There is also option to run the open query, and then you can run the R query and get, and slice and dice it according to what you would like to do there. And then you can export this information to a CSV or whatever you would like to do there.
Okay, so this whole information, everything that you see on the recommendation is also available via ARG.
Right. Yes, and of course you can update the query itself here, right? Mm-hmm. And then you can add more information or filter out something that you don't want to get there.
Great. All right. Then it's great stuff. Thanks for taking the time to demonstrate this. There is any final consideration that you have in mind for our audience when they are planning to implement this feature or maintaining or something else that you want to share?
Yes. First of all, I would like to, to ask people to go and onboard this stuff. Even if, when we talked at the beginning, the North Star is securing the runtime. But as early as you detect the vulnerability, it's going to be much more secure. And what's more important, it's going to be much more productive to you to fix stuff as early as possible. Think about the developer that needs to do his work. It's much easier for him to get a notification that he needs to do something before the image went live, rather than something that is going to be, in your production environment, and then you need to go to developer and rush him to fix it then. Then, if you detect stuff in the registry level, it's going to be much easier for your devs to work. And when we go live with, with the CI/CD stuff, the scan on the CI/CD pipeline, which is now in preview, it's going to be even closer to developer. Then, as early as you ask the developer to fix stuff, it's going to be easier for him to do the work.
Yeah, so that's really the shift left, the whole idea of the shift left.
Yep, exactly.
Excellent. Thanks a lot, Denis. I truly appreciate you taking the time to talk to us about container registry and demonstrate that for us. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. And everyone, thank you very much for your audience. Make sure to share this video. Make sure to subscribe to Microsoft Security Channel. And stay tuned for more episodes of Azure Security Center in the Field. See you next time.